Pity and Lonely by Jonathan J. Gagin. In the land where the forests are overgrown, and the night is dark, is where the monsters are, and of the monsters, none is grimmer and darker than the pity monster, whose coat does not reflect the light, and such is it that he feels unseen, so nobody loves his furry coat. His pretty eyes, long horns, as he is as dark as night. The pity monster wanders alone, and so he was alone one night, invisible to the naked eye, when he ran into lonely monster, who was always well alone, and thus lonely. So said pity monster, "Oh, what's the use? He'll never see me." And lonely monster, who was extra lonely, that evening said in reply, "I don't know who said that, but he couldn't be talking to me." And pity monster suddenly cried, "You can hear me?" And lonely monster said, "Yeah." And lonely monster got an idea. "Do you want to be my friend voice?" he said, and pity monster whined, "Yeah, I guess, but you'll never see me." And so replied lonely monster, "Yeah, I have a friend, but why do you care if I see you?" And pity monster said, "It's a self-image thing." And lonely monster asked, "Can you see you?" And pity monster replied, "No." And so lonely monster replied, "Well, there's your problem." And he took a bucket of paint and replied, "I have an idea. Why don't you paint yourself so you decide what you look like? Forget what you look like to others." And that's exactly what Pity Monster did.